Mr. Nasheed, the Maldivian government has denied that there was any deal reached. In fact, that they had given any assurance that you would not be arrested ahead of the elections. How worried are you that you would be arrested?
I am extremely worried, and the situation is very, very precarious. Right now, they seem to have restrained themselves from instantly trying to arrest me. But the situation still continues. I still have the court case upon me. And just recently, a day before yesterday, when I wanted to travel for a cultural function in Abu Dhabi, the government did not allow me to travel. So there is much restraint. And at the same time, because the violent nature of the coup, and as I remain, they are unfinished business, I am worried that anti-vigilant means and methods may be used upon me as well. You will know that even as recently as last week, a number of journalists were very badly beaten up, and many, many regime dissenters in opposition to the government have been violently attacked. And therefore, it is an issue of serious concern to us.
You say that, yet what sort of a role can India really play? Because many say you, in fact, forced India's hand, pushed it into an awkward corner over this issue by just simply appearing at the Indian High Commission. They couldn't force you out. And yet they faced that charge from the Maldivian government, who said India was meddling in Maldives' internal affairs.
We must understand that there is no love for the Indian government by the government here in the Maldives now, not the people of the Maldives. The people of the Maldives very clearly understand that their development and their betterment remains linked to what is happening in India. Indian rapid economic development and Maldives must be able to plug into that development. I think the people of Maldives, they are very clear. Of course, there are sections of the society who are xenophobic, racist, nationalistic, and full of religious bigotry. And they do keep inflaming these ideas of bigotry. But we believe that the vast majority of the people of the Maldives wants to be more international, be more connected to the rest of the world. And therefore, India can play a very crucial role in consolidating democracy, in assisting growth of democracy in the Maldives. And also, at the same time, it is, I believe, in India's own interest to make sure that there is political stability in the Maldives. When that doesn't happen, there is always room for other powers and other countries to move into situations or move into affairs of the Maldives. What I did see in recent days was how India was practicing, or rather how it has been projecting its newly gained superpower or regional power position and role. India's projection of power is very, very soft and very, very amicable. Compared to, let's say, other emerging superpowers during the last century or even this century. I think India is playing a very good role, and I think India should continue to play that role and be engaged in the Maldives.
Given that role you see for India, if you were to come to power, if you were to become president again, would you restore the GMR deal?
Well, direct foreign investment is a key policy. It's one of the cornerstone economic policies of our government. And we want to liberalize trade. We want to attract foreign investments. And the GMR contract in that regard was one of the best contracts that we signed. It would benefit the people of the Maldives. It would increase tourism. It would give us a brand new airport. And it would also relieve us from further international debt. And we still believe that it is a good contract, and we believe that the government had no right unilaterally, the cabinet had no right unilaterally to disengage from the contract or to dissolve the contract.
But will you actually restore that deal? Is that a commitment you can give?
I'm sure it had to be done. It has to be done. We will restore the contract when we come into government, and it will be done again transparently and according to the legal procedures available here.
I have to ask then, why the Indian High Commission, many speculating about the fact that you had been given an assurance that you could take refuge there. We know that you were in India a week before you went in there.
I did not speak to the Indian government on my intentions, or I did not have any intention to walk into the Indian High Commission when I came back from India. I was in India for 2 days. I had conversations with your government officials, and also I had a few evenings with some friends. I have a number of friends in Delhi, and I enjoy it. But I did not talk about, and we did not discuss going into the Indian High Commission. And in fact, I did not think about going into the Indian High Commission. When I came back to Malé, and when they wanted to sentence me almost in summary, in an illegal court through irregular means, then there was nothing else I could do. That was an end of a line for me, and I really had to do it, and then I did it. I'm glad that the Indian government was kind enough to look me after, and I'm glad there is, even though precarious, even though not so very firm, but there is some contours of an understanding between the Indian government and the Maldives government.